the frame of the saddle, the heart of the saddle, and what is very expensive to repair is the interior, the tree. Okay, so when you buy a saddle, okay, what is covered in leather and has foam and wool flocking, the skeleton of the horse and rider is visible here, but the skeleton of the saddle is not visible here. So how do I know that the skeleton of the saddle is okay? And I'm talking about the saddle tree. So there are certain ways you can do, which I'm going to demonstrate quick, how you can test if the tree is okay. But in order to, I want to show you a picture before I turn that off. I want to show you the different types of trees that are out there. Okay, so the old army saddles had big bars. The Western saddles have a little bit less width where the thigh is. And then the English saddle has steel reinforced bars right through here. So I'm gonna blow this up a little bit. What you're gonna see here, as soon as I got that arranged, there you go. This is all steel. So this wood tree, they're very inexpensive. This is made out of one piece. The good ones have 16 pieces wood glued and laminated together in the shape. So in order not to break and reinforce it, everywhere on the side, everywhere you see it's steel plated. So if you have a wood tree, 99% it's really a steel tree, and that steel tree gives a little bit. So I'm going to switch cameras now, or I'm gonna stop that screen share to share with you a couple things. Okay, where's my first? Here you go. So here is the first, this is all steel. And I can bend this a little bit. That's why they call that spring tree, because if I bend it a little bit, okay, so if you apply 180 pounds, that's a lot of pressure, it gives a little bit. But the steel tree, also wood tree, it's not meant to give a lot or to be changed to the horse. So when you have a saddle, you buy your used saddles, you want to make sure there's absolutely no wrinkles in the seat and you don't have any movement between, well, the points from here to here. So I'm going to demonstrate. So here's the wood tree. There's a little give in it, and it gives a little bit. So that's that wood tree, also steel tree, is not broken. Now I'm gonna put my knees where my hands are and squish that as hard as I can together. And I'm gonna switch the camera for that. Hopefully you guys can see that better. There you go. So right here now, I put my knees between. I gotta get the camera a little bit better position there. So now I'm squishing my knees really, really hard. There should be no give. Okay, so if I force it a lot, this is a relatively inexpensive, cheap wood tree. I could easily break that with my legs. So that's how you test if a saddle is broken. To another tree, this one here. Okay, so many, many companies use a binate tree, adapt tree, or flex tree. These are the more modern saddles. They're not as heavy and they're not as brittle as the steel tree or wood trees. Those are very, very strong materials because you can flex them literally in half, okay? Also in the front. So the material itself never breaks. It's just super stuff. Sometimes for light purpose, it gets weight purpose, it gets cut out pieces, so you see here. And also like the wood tree, it has a bracket in front But the difference with flex tree, adapt tree, or binary tree and DIY trees, all those, they can be adjusted in here, because you see the rivets are only attached in the sides, not in the center. So here, there's several different adjustments machine. One machine just make the tree narrow or wide in the angle. Other machines can make the width wider and independent of the angle. So that's different tools available. So this tree here has either, you can see here on the side, a short spring steel, and sometimes you can make a longer one or a thicker one, depends how heavy the weight of the rider is. Now, the most important aid is the rider's seat. The rider's seat is the rider's weight. So this saddle here, it's a typical dressage saddle, looking at the size. So this is a relatively large saddle. It's an 18-inch saddle. So this person here is a flex tree, and this is weighted for a person who weighs around 150 pounds. So you will see on a flex tree, I can easily move this, and you will see wrinkles here. Now, when that would be a wood tree, I would say the tree is broken, okay? Because that's not meant to do that. But if it's an adapt tree, flex tree, DIY tree, or binary tree, they're meant to give with the horse's back. And just like the wrinkles on the shoe, they will have wrinkles in the seat if the saddle moves so much. So then again, from the front, same thing. You put them between your legs like that. Squish it very, very hard. And if there's any movement, then that bracket is broken. Another, if this is broken, you can take your hands, easy move your hands apart, and it will be broken. Now for a tip, how to look for used saddle for billets, always look at the billets from the bottom. You want to see any cracks. If bend them slightly, you don't want them to bend. You can see this leather is very, very dry, very hard. Okay, so that's something you can definitely bring back to life. Sometimes if this leather, you bend it and it cracks immediately, then the leather is dead. It means it rottens from the inside out, and then I wouldn't go with this. So this old saddle, just to have a little bit dryness to it, but it's not necessary a wrong or bad shape. This is a typical used saddle. These saddles are very popular because they're very soft in the beginning and because they use very thin leather. So this is just cosmetic repairs. You see the wear and tear. So that is something what I wouldn't be too worried about it. If I buy this saddle used, oh well, that's annoying to ride with this, but it's easy to repair. It's just a big cost to it. This, however, is a bigger repair, and you see this very often when manufacturers put saddles wrong together, or they put the rider, who's a female, rides in a male saddle. You see how this is ripped right there? Now, that's a big problem because that's a very expensive repair to do. And the reason why it's broken here, from the wear and tear outside, either it's bad craftsmanship, or this saddle is made for a male rider. That means when the male seat bone sits inside, you see it sits clearly inside the foam, away from the seam. And then when the rider can pivot on that. But this saddle, as we know, the majority of the riders are women. Here you see a woman pelvis, and you see you're sitting on the edge. And that's, of course, exactly where this kind of motion will happen. All right, so very often, not remember what I said in my previous, if you ride in a non-gender appropriate saddle, never mind your back, never mind the horse's damage you do, the saddle is not meant to be rubbed and shaved on here. Then I look on the bottom, you know, I want to see if this channel is not too narrow. Sometimes I see stitches here, that's just minor cosmetic. Then I look at billets. You know, the billets here, this is what we call cracked. So be careful on this, because this can last a long time, or it can easily break when you write. So when you bend it and you see that them crack like that, you want to be very careful, because this can go from one day to the next. All of a sudden you have no girth. So these are the main points what I recommend when you look for a used saddle.